Hello. Cheers. Well, about 2.5 weeks ago, I brewed an APA. It fermented at about 63, 64 degrees for, well, up until 2 days ago. At about 10 days, I added some dry hops to it, and it's been dry hopping now since almost a week ago. And now it's ready for me to bottle it and keg it. So I've got my bottle sitting over here ready to go. Got a keg on the floor here ready to go. I'm going to quick carb it with my quick carbonator over here. And with any luck, I'll have a nice fresh carbonated APA in about an hour or an hour and a half. So I'm gonna get started here. I'll stop back every once in a while and show you my progress as I move along. Bottles are all sanitized, the keg's all sanitized. I brought the beer out of my beer fridge, and I've had it cold crashing now for going on 3 days. So all the trub and everything should be down to the bottom. I'm gonna fill the keg first, and then I'm gonna fill my bottling bucket over here, and I'll bottle from that. And while I'm bottling, I'm going to quick carb it with my quick carbonator. So, anyway, follow along. Well, there's the beer right there. Again, it's an APA. I fermented it with some harvested Rogue Pac-Man yeast that I got out of a Christmas beer about 2 months ago. And I've got my hose sanitizing right now for the bottling bucket. Get it out of here. Spray this down. Got a little bit of a cold, so I'm really, really sanitizing and being careful. Everything is good. Push this up. Hose clamp up here on the spout. I don't want any air being sucked down into the hose. Okay, and here we go. All right, well, we'll give that 5 or 10 minutes and see how it goes. And actually, I'm going to watch it pretty close because I want to see what happens when it gets down to where the hop bag is. I'm going to go ahead and open up the lid. And we'll take a look inside. Yeah, that's the top of it. A little bit of yeast on the top. Not too much, but we'll do our best not to get that into anything. You can see the string in the side for the hops. I'm hoping that they've sunk to the bottom and they won't affect anything, but I will keep a good eye on that. And there it is going in there. You listen real close. Don't hear any splashing or noise or anything, so it's not oxygenating. One thing I did do before I started the process after I sanitized the keg is I shot some CO2 into it just to hose off my CO2 tank for about 30 seconds just to create a blanket on the bottom. Hopefully the beer is just going to push that up and help get the oxygen out. We will of course bleed the keg really good before I start the carbonating. Well, the beer has drained out of the fermentation vessel. I'm just up to just underneath where my gas input is. The gas input is flush with the underside of this, so I left about a quarter inch below that. So we'll close this up and I'll burp it with CO2 about a dozen times. I've read some charts recently and had some conversations back and forth in homebrew talk to where they say you only want about 15 parts per million of oxygen in your beer. That's what the professional brewers shoot for. And there's a chart there that says to get that, you pretty much got to burp your keg at 30 pounds almost a dozen times. So that's just what I'm going to do. Don't want any oxygenation. Anyway, I'm going to move forward here and we'll come back. All right, I've moved my keg out of the way, put my bucket in place. See that nice color coming out of that? That's going to be very, very good. Looking back here, I'm down to where the hop bag sits, and I actually think that hop bag's probably in a pretty good spot. I'm not going to mess with it. I'm just going to let it sit there and get as much beer as I can out of there without pulling out any trub and yeast. I will wash this yeast. It's Pac-Man yeast. I harvested it. I definitely want to wash it because it's a good yeast. And I tell you, it went from 1060 down to 1025 in under 3 days. It was amazing how fast that thing ate up all the sugars. And it tastes really good, everything I've tasted while I've been checking the gravities. Wish you could taste it, wish you could smell it. All done. Looks like I got close to 5 liters, or almost about a gallon and a half of beer in there. Got down right to the top of the trub. I think that's as good as I'm going to get. It left, I can't really see the markings in the bottle, but looks like I left about a half gallon. I have to remember that. Anyway, time to move on. Okay, quick update. Got my carbonating device now, running sanitizer through it. You may have seen this in a previous video. Down here, I've got a T-fitting with the carbonating stone going in on the left. Beer and wort's going to come through the top of the pump, exit the bottom of the pump, and it's going to pick up gas on the way. So I've got sanitizer pumping through here. Okay, well, you know, there are tons of videos on burping a keg, but I'm going to go ahead and show you anyway. So what I do here is I've got my keg hooked up to my gas. Right now I got my gas turned at somewhere in the neighborhood of 20 pounds. I'm going to crank that up to about 30. And I'm going to squirt the top of my keg just to make sure I don't got any leaks. I won't do a lot of good if I have leaks. And I don't. So. There's one. Like I said before, I read that if you do this about a dozen times, that's really the best thing to do. That was one. And I'm going to turn my gas on and off each time. Kind of lost count, but I think that was 8. 9. 10. 11. And I'll have to do a good one. 12. Now I talked to some brewers and they say, some professional brewers, to get the headspace up to about 30 pounds when you get started on this. So that's where I'm going to put it right now, and I'm going to pop this off of the keg, leave that there. Now what I need to do is move this fitting. I got to take the the gas fitting off of here, and I'm going to put it on the carbonator. So what I'm going to do with that, though, is I'm going to go ahead and turn off the pump for a minute here. And I'm going to stop for a minute while I arrange all the fittings. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to purge the lines of sanitizer with the CO2. So I got the gas hooked up over here on the carbonation stone. And I'm going to run some gas through the lines and get the sanitizer out with CO2. Especially the one that I really want it out of the keg line, because I don't want to push sanitizer back into my beer. So open this. Ooh. Well, that wasn't very smart. Okay. I guess you want to hold the hoses when you do that. Learn something there. It's only the second time I've done this, so. Okay. I'm gonna crimp off this one. And I'll turn off my gas. So I should have CO2 in the lines. No air. Now, here are my lines. Again, the top one goes to the beverage out. The bottom fitting is going to go to the gas. Out. Gas in, excuse me. So I'm going to put these on here. And I actually need to get my other fitting. And I don't really want to do that yet till I get the other one in. But give me a minute here. Come right back. Okay, I'm going to do one last purge of the lines. Now, remember the top fitting here on the pump is going to be the liquid out. So, black for beverage. Okay, the other fitting is going to end up being the gas out. But what I want to do is I'm going to first turn the pump on, and I'm going to let some stuff come out. Pump's a self-priming pump. Sometimes it takes a minute to prime itself, and it's getting there. Come on. There we go. Get all the air out of line, and get that out. Turn the pump off. And put the fitting on. Okay, so, again, and I guess while I got this, one more time. Okay, so here we go. We're ready to put it in. Got that on the gas, out in, so. And this on the beverage out. Okay, so I'm going to turn my gas down a little bit, and we're ready to go here. So go ahead and gas on, burp a little bit, and now I'm going to turn the pump on. And we're starting to carbonate. Like I said, right now I've got it set at about 25 pounds, and you turn that down to about 10. Okay. Alright. Now we just time it. It needs to go for about an hour. Well, it's been going for, I don't know, 8 to 10 minutes right now. Let me show you what we got here. Again, the beer comes out of the beverage outline,
and goes in to the top of the pump. And once it exits the pump, it comes out the bottom, goes through the carbonating stone fitting, and then comes out the bottom. Now you'll notice the difference between the top and the bottom. It's fairly clear, and down here it's somewhat cloudy, because you can see the bubbles going through it. Up here you can kind of see it too. If this was a darker beer, you'd really be able to tell. But you can see the bubbles flowing back in. Now eventually the pressure is going to equalize in that keg from the CO2 flowing in. Now I want this beer to be carbonated at about 2.2. It's an IPA. IPAs go between 2.2 and 2.6. So I've got a chart, and you can look at these charts on the internet. I'm not going to be able to focus it in. But anyway, the chart says that my beer right now, which was at about 36 degrees, to get it up to 2.2 to 2.4, 2.6 carbonation volumes, needs to be pressurized at approximately 10 to 12 pounds. So what I need to do is adjust my fitting here up a little bit to where I'm going to about 10 pounds. Now I could go a little higher, maybe try to make this go a little faster, but I'm not in a big hurry. You heard when I turned that up, the pump strained a little bit. You look up here and you can really see the bubbling going in now. Over time, that bubbling is going to decrease and eventually go away. When the bubbling goes away and it looks like I'm not getting much in the way of gas going in there, should be done. I think that's going to be in about 50 minutes. It's been about 20 minutes. Still going strong. Still got bubbles flowing in there. Once this is done, I'm going to put in my kegerator, let it sit for a little bit to settle. I'll probably kick the pressure up just a hair. What I'll probably do is bleed the pressure out of it, put it in the kegerator, and let it go in standard keg pressure. I don't want it backflowing into my keg. Into my CO2, and hopefully I'll get to taste this a little later tonight. Last time I made one of these videos, I forgot to show the perfect pour, but this time I won't do that. Anyway, while I'm waiting for the next half hour or so, I think I'll get to bottling the rest of that beer. Shouldn't take me very long. I only got about a gallon and a half, so that's only about 15-20 bottles at the most. All right, got my bottling set up. Got my bottling wand. Notice this bottling one has a spring load on the bottom. I really like that. I also use hose clamps to hold everything snug. You will notice over here, I got my Avenator. If you don't have one of these, you gotta get it. In that Avenator is star sand, and that's where all my caps are. But you take this thing and you can take your bottle and swirl in the stars on the bottom, but up on top here, if you push down, it sprays star sand up there, and your bottle comes right out. That is the easiest way to sanitize bottles ever. I've used that helping breweries, and they've got Avenator when they're filling bombers, and I'll tell you, it's a dream if you're not wanting to stick your bottles into a bucket of star sand. You just take this thing, squirt it up there, comes right out, and you got sanitized bottle. When I do them, then I take my bottles and put them over here on my little bottling rack. I have a video on this. It's just some wood with some wood screws in it, screwed in, painted, sprayed down with star sand before I use it, and it works really good. Anyway, back to bottling. All right, well, looks like I got about 15 bottles out of that. I hope to get between 25 and 30. Now, I'm going to do something that I like to do when I'm bottling. I don't know if it does any good, but when you're bottling, you've got that little head space there. Now, if you use something like a Blickman gun or a counterflow filler, you can squirt CO2 in the bottle and it'll push it out with the beer. I don't go to that extreme, but I let the beer push out the oxygen. But then what I like to do is I like to top off my beer in the bottles with a little bit of CO2. They got it right here, and I just put some CO2 in there and try and force all the oxygen out. A couple or 3 seconds seems to be enough. Then I don't have to worry about any oxygenation happening with my beer. CO2 is heavier than oxygen, so it's going to sit on top of the beer. Now I'll cap them. Okay, it's been going for a little over an hour now, and if you'll notice, both lines are clear. A little bit of condensation in this one, both of them, but there's nothing bubbly wise going through there. Look down here on the floor, there's a little bit of backwash from the keg, and there's no CO2 going through that. Temperature up here is right at about 12, just for the heck of it. I'm going to kick the temperature up just a bit, see if I can force some up. Oh, look at that. So I could have kicked it up a little more, pour some more in there. And right now I got it about 20, but I don't want it that high, so back it off a little bit, see what happens. I'm going to open it up a little bit, it's up to about 20, cutting it back down to around 10, 12, and it's reached equilibrium. Can't push any more CO2 through there. So, now it's time to be finished with carbonation. I'm going to put it in my keyser, let it sit for about 20-25 minutes, and we'll try a pour. Right now, I'm going to turn my gas off. And I'm turning the line off here so don't get any backwash into it. And switch the pump. And we are good. I hope. Alright, I got everything unhooked. I'm gonna go ahead and bleed the pressure out. Whoa, plenty in there. Now, it makes me think what I'm going to do when I put it on the keyser is just hook it up to the tap and not up to the gas tonight. Let's see what happens. Well, it's been about a half hour, a little less, since I put the keg in the keyser. I tried to bleed it right away, as you might remember. It was all over the place. Now it's doing pretty good. Okay. So, I bled all the gas pressure off, so that'll allow me to put my regular gas line on, and it won't backflow into the other lines. And get my fan out of the way. Here's my beer line. Okay, I have star sand in here, so I'm going to get as much out as I can. So, let's see. Let's step back a bit. And okay. Alright, I'm gonna step back a little bit. And okay, got the line here with star sand. I'm gonna hold it up. Now, I'm gonna use a little trick I know. Take a battery, put the battery in there, and you can push on the battery, put the battery in there, you can push on the battery, and it'll push your poppet down. It's a heck of a lot easier than trying to push something in there. Let's open this up. Oh, it's going. Yeah, not much there. Alright, so, put the line on. Okay, got the star sand out. Now let's see what happens. You notice I got a little bit of foaminess when I first poured it. So here goes nothing. Let's make sure I get a real good shot on this. Because I don't want to... Alright. Ooh, we got some bubbling there. Well, guess we got some definite carbonation. Yeah. Give that a little bit of time to come down, but it's definitely carbonated. Let's see if we can get over here in the light. And I can't really tell if I got bubbles going up there or not. I'm sure there are. And the head's going down. Now comes the true test. How's it taste? Well, that tastes good. That's pretty good. And it definitely tastes carbonated. No CO2 flavor. That's good beer. I'm going to pour me a little more. Okay, well, all done for the night. Pretty much all cleaned up. Got a nice beer poured here. Got my yeast washing over here. And you can already see it separating. I'll probably combine these into a third bottle in half hour, 45 minutes or so. And that's all she wrote. Hope you learned a little bit of something. I got the carbonator all cleaned out, ran some hot soapy water through it, and then some clear water through it after that, and got all my vessels cleaned, everything ready to go. That sometimes takes longer than the actual process. So I got 5 gallons carbonated beer, 15 bottles that'll probably carbonate within a couple weeks, and I can drink it right away. Got pretty good head retention, but you guys have a great time. Make some beer, drink some beer. Cheers.